Tonight, we are going to witness the most anticipated match. Are you ready?
Hey, how's it going? Yeah, so today we're doing it a bit gay. You know, we're tapping into that half of my sexuality. We're the straight part. Fucking go. Forget about it. Forget about it. Women, you're off the table. I'm sorry. I know. I mean, let me put the statistics up right now. I know you guys are really sad to hear that, but it's just how it is. I don't really know. Why did I do this? You have no idea. I spent like 2 hours setting this all up just so I could wear a turtleneck for a video. So if you haven't seen this before, this is basically just a bunch of jokes, kind of sketch, stand-up kind of shit, similar to a previous video called December. I'm just keeping the name. Fuck it. It was because it was the month, but nah, it's just a series. This is the December series. What does that mean? Nothing. What does it entail? Everything. We also got this little mic here. I spent about 10 minutes fucking attaching this to my turtleneck. Fucking hell. Get a look at these, right? Checkered. Your fucking favorite YouTuber doesn't wear checkered fucking trousers for you, alright? Subscribe! Like! Comment! Tell me how gay I look, alright? But it's good gay, because I'm bi, so therefore, when I say gay, I mean like, yeah. Like fucking, pride flat. What am I saying? Stick to the script, looker. If you know me in real life, then you know that I never stop talking. I mean, I spent a whole school year doing that. Shout out the physics squad, you know what I'm saying? But I understand, I've realized that sometimes when, you know, I'm saying my ridiculously over the top, silly things, which are just jam packed full of knowledge, that sometimes it can annoy people a little. And this isn't intentional. I would hate to unintentionally annoy someone. You know, it would really, really hurt me to my inner soul to know I was annoying someone and I didn't even know about it. But not for the reason you might think. You see, I love annoying people. But knowing that I am unintentionally annoying someone and not getting to relish and enjoy every second of their uncomfortableness as they sit there just hating me, that really grinds my gears. It's like, you know, knowing you're missing out on all that pleasure. Because I enjoy making people laugh as well, but if I'm gonna annoy someone, I might as well enjoy it. It's like if you got invited to a fucking... It's like if you got invited to a house with like 40 porn stars and your fucking invitation got lost in the mail, like... That'd be mind-blowing. But I remember like one time I saw that, like I wasn't really like into it, but it's like how does the distribution of those 40 women really get used, right? Like, think about that, 40 women and one man, like... Because maybe you can only get like 10 on at once, and then 10, and that 10 can range from like, obviously, you know, to just touching, like, you know, like, I'll just... A bird just hit my window. Oh my god! Bird just hit my window. Oh my god. I don't know if you could hear it, but it was just... Boom! And it just flew away. Fucking heard me talking about the porn stars. Anyway, it's like, what do the other 30 do in that situation? Is there like a rotation? Is there like, you know, is it like, okay, you get 5 minutes, you know, sucking his dick. You get 5 just kind of like rubbing his back. And then switch over and then, you know, Crystal can take your place. It's like, how does that work? It just seems unrealistic. And it seems like a real waste of like, humans, you know what I mean? Like, those other 30 porn stars could have been like doing their taxes or like construction, and instead they're just kind of sitting there like, yeah, I mean, I guess it makes the man really makes you think. Also, do porn stars get catering? Think about that. Like, but what kind of snacks do they get? I mean, it's not an easy job, you know. Only the pros can do it, and I just wonder what kind of food do they get given? Sandwiches? And, like, what? Are they decent? Are they just kind of like, about Tesco? Or do they, like, bring in, like, a chef, you know, a caterer? My neighbor's pulling up. Is that the one that fucking scammed a bunch of old people when he worked at a bank? Yeah, I think so. Shut the fuck up! During quarantine, I started watching a lot more TV, and I ended up addicted to watching this show called 90 Day Fiancé. And I've binged every season now, but it's just still crazy, the idea that this person will go across the world to go meet the person with a camera crew, and they will get engaged to a 90-day-year-old baby. I mean, imagine being engaged to a baby. It's just crazy what they'll do on TV these days. One of the people who was getting engaged ended up killing himself because one of these babies cheated on him with someone else. And it's like, come on, man, like, there's plenty of other babies out there under 90 days. Like, it's not that big a deal, right? The 90-day baby market is thriving. It wasn't your one chance. There's always gonna be 90-day-old babies. I'll tell you the biggest problem with that show, though, as much as I love it. The catfishes. All these babies pretending to be 90 days old when they're really like almost a year old. And sometimes they are the right age, but the baby looks nothing like the photos. I mean, imagine that. A catfishing baby. Oh, also, I've never watched the show. Here's a fun game for you kids at home. Look up your birthday, right? Check Wikipedia and see what natural disasters happened on that day and how many people died, you know? I can't remember who it was, but someone, like a whole fucking school got shot up on the day they were born. Me, on the other hand, some fucking guy flew a balloon really far. No deaths or anything. The guy was okay. I guess maybe one day I'll get added to a Wikipedia page for, like, look who was born this day. Could you believe it, you know? It seems like I deserve a birthday. Wait, what? I don't just deserve a Wikipedia page. I deserve a goddamn listing on this 22nd of September. Mark your calendar. Yeah. International waters. A body of water that no specific country owns. Therefore, no laws apply to it. I know, extremely interesting. But if the laws of countries don't apply, do the laws between our fellow man not apply? Such as the just homies laws, you know? Like, so if you were in international waters and you just really wanted to live out your closeted gay fantasy, you know, and you wanted to have sex with a man, would that be gay? Because, I mean, international waters, would it count? Would you be able to just get away with that? You know, and if you were like, oh, I really want to have sex with a man, but I don't want it to be gay, you know, I'm sure there's some of you out there, you know, like below if you want to have sex with a man, but you're not gay. The thing is, though, it's a double-edged sword because, right, so if you fuck a man, if you fuck the same sex, it's not gay. But what if somehow you ended up on a yacht with, like, you know, some really, so I don't know, like, well, like Emma Watson or maybe someone with a bit less morals, like Megan Fox or Margot Robbie, like, and you're on a boat with them, and it's like, you know, when you're on a boat and you're in international waters, it's kind of, you just kind of have to have sex, but. That wouldn't count then, would it? Because that's an international war. So if you had sex with Margot Robbie, you couldn't go home. Hey guys, you know that one bitch in Wolf of Wall Street? You couldn't. It wouldn't count. I mean, I don't know if why anyone would believe you in the first place, but, like, you know, you can't put that in your Facebook bio or post it to r/sounding, because international wars, it's... Man, that would suck. And it could have been your favorite day of all time, the best thing to ever happen to you. And technically, it never even happened. It's like if a tree falls in the woods, but there's no one there to hear it. Did it even make a sound? If you have sex with Margot Robbie in international waters, did you even fuck? Why do I subject myself to this? It's like I've got like the fucking biggest window in the fucking world possible looking in on me in this outfit. Fucking turtleneck, camera, light. What the fuck am I thinking? Oh man. Why do I keep getting women's self-defense videos in my recommended on YouTube? Huh? Why? Why, YouTube? Why would I need to know how to defend myself against a man? First of all, I am a man. I don't need to defend myself against myself. Second of all, do I look like I need help doing that? I mean, come on. What kind of games are you trying to play, YouTube? You know very well. No matter who it was, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, Jack Black. Kanye West, I'd fucking beat them all up, I don't give a shit. I don't need any help. It doesn't matter the fucking gender either, Kim Kardashian, I'm coming for you next. Fucking hit you off balance, fall over, crack your skull. I didn't do it. The thing is as well, they know I'm not a woman based off of what I watch, my gender assigned to YouTube, my massive intellect, my muscles. So why would they be recommending me women's self-defense videos? What good reason would YouTube have to recommend me that? Why would YouTube be doing that? Unless... YouTube is trying to teach me all the tricks and tactics that women could use against me if I ever attack them. YouTube's trying to train me on how to stop the defenses of women if I ever attack them. But I would never want to do that, guys. I mean, just look at me. Why would I ever want to attack a poor, defenseless woman? I'm no brute. I wouldn't do that. I love you guys. I mean, I'm going full gay this episode, so I don't love you like that. I love you like, you know, my home gal, my... my queens, Who the fuck's car is pulling up right in front of my house? What? Sess. That's it, Sess. Come on, Sess. I would never attack you guys, alright, Sess? I would never do that. But to all my queens and sisters out there, I would never want to attack you guys. I'm on your side. I would never want to do that. But YouTube is telling me to. I can't stop myself. Must watch videos on how to attack women. I think there's about to be an Amazon parcel, man, at my door. This is gonna be quite awkward. Thanks. See ya. Why did I say see ya? I don't fucking know the guy. Well, I guess I got this now. I said see ya. I'm not gonna ever see him again. God damn it. Fuck you. Oh my god. Oh. Just fell back in my chair.